Hey guys, welcome to the Aran 360 video of Inis Oírr, the smallest island of the Aran Islands, just off the west coast of County Clare and County Galway in Ireland. Here we are near the pier and close to Ballyon Lurgan and the beach. The rocks are a massive part of Inis Oírr. It's an extension of the burn, which of course is well known for its massive amount of limestone rocks. Here we have the shipwreck of the MV Plassey. It could be instantly recognisable to anyone who's watched the opening credits of Father Ted. Originally it was known as Juliet, named after Juliet of Romeo and Juliet fame, and it was used as a minesweeper by the Royal Navy in World War II. It operated close to the UK, but was deployed in Operation Torch in 1942, which was an operation where the Allies invaded French North Africa, which was controlled at the time by Vichy France, which of course was part of the Axis. After the war, it was recommissioned as a cargo vessel and used by the British Merchant Service under the name Peter John. In 1951, the Limerick Steamship Company took hold of it and renamed it Plassey to the area of Limerick which the University of Limerick now stands. It operated for nearly 9 years until the 8th of March 1960, where it was caught in a massive storm and ran onto the rocks, but it was actually not pushed ashore until a few weeks later. There was a second storm that pushed it into its current spot. Fortunately, the crew were rescued by brave locals using a breeches buoy, which is a bit like combining a life buoy and a zipline. Still prone to the odd shift in heavy breezes, and it's fairly rusted at this stage. We move on to the Inis Oírr Lighthouse, or the Fardur's Point Lighthouse. It's actually one of four lighthouses on the Aran Islands, and the most easterly of the Aran lighthouses. It was built and first lit in 1857, and is 112 foot tall. It's currently operated by the Commissioners of Irish Lights, the group who run Irish lighthouses. There are two small houses next to the lighthouse, where the lighthouse keepers used to live. Now it's a bit more modern, and there's a person living a nice distance from the lighthouse monitoring it via radio link. And can be seen for 18 nautical miles with the white light and 11 miles nautical miles with the red light. As we found out on the day, unlike, for example, the lighthouse located near Kilkee in County Clare, this lighthouse is close to the public most of the time. You can see wonderful views around here though. Thank you.
Next up is O'Brien's Castle. It's one of the highest points on the island, and as you can see if you look around, it's pretty much a good view of the whole island. It was built in the 1400s by the O'Briens, who were a massive force in Ireland, especially in Munster and Clare. It was taken by the O'Flahertys around 1582, which is probably why it's in Galway now instead of Clare. Cromwellian conquest of Ireland, it was actually taken and ruined, which is pretty typical of that tug. Inisoírr really is a lovely spot. Certainly a place to go if you want to get away from things and have a nice bit of peace and quiet. What I really noticed was the quality of the water, how clear it was and how clean it was. Way back, we actually went to Doolin Ferry's on scenic route near Cliffs of Moher. Hearing the guide and the background, you might get a better idea of what's going on, so I'll stay quiet.
Consists of razorbills and puffins. Islands are the most famous bird here at the Cliffs of Moher. And we last see them on any mountains or standing on the cliff edge. The easiest way to see a puffin is through the water all around us. They will be sitting there at random, and they stand out with their colourful beak and colourful flippers. But be aware that a puffin is a very, very small bird and will be hard to see at times. Until they're ready to migrate south for the winter. They will start migrating south through